Welcome, welcome. I'm here with Giselle Allen, and I'm so excited to chat with you today. Giselle is in the first phase of embodied abundance, which is all about reinforcing the stuff that's already working for you and doubling down onto your authenticity. So I'm really excited. Welcome, Giselle.
Thanks for having me. I'm so excited to be having this chat, and I'm so excited to meet the beautiful souls who join your program.
Yeah, it's going to be so good. I'm really excited. So tell us all about your business. What is it you do? What is your magic?
Yes. Okay. So I am a mindset coach of for women of color entrepreneurs. So what does that mean to me? To me, it means number one, basically any woman of color entrepreneur, any like mind trash that you have going on, we deal with it. But my favorite stuff to talk about is really all around decolonizing the way that you show up, and that's inside and outside your business. So it might be like with your strategy, or it might be in really showing up in your full brilliance, integrating your identities as a woman of color entrepreneur, and just showing up boldly and unapologetically in every single part of your business, knowing that every single piece of you is like 100% perfect, 100% right, and all the things that make you feel like they aren't right are usually steeped in racism, patriarchy, or capitalism.
Amen. Amen. For real though. Like for sure. Yeah. I love that because, and I love that you also teach, your default is to teach to women of color, which I think is incredible because even though, I work with everybody, like most people teach to white students and white enrollees. And I love the fact that like no matter who that like the women of color who are in this program are going to be the default for it, like for like that class. Definitely. I mean, my intention was diversifying and Giselle helped me with that, which I'm so grateful that she did. But I'm so glad that that's like an experience that everybody's going to get to have, not just for the people who have never had that before, but the people who have had the benefit of being the default. So I think it's going to be incredible to like be able to filter that experience for them because of course we all deal with this, but in our own ways, right?
Totally. I think it's a really cool experience. I have a lot of folks who are non-POCs that still follow me. They're on my list. Like they like gobble up all my stuff. And I think it's a really great experience, not just for the women and femmes of color, but also for other folks to number one experience that like you can teach to the most marginalized folks in your group and everyone will glean value from it instead of like forcing them 24/7 to glean like the little bit of value from everything else. So yeah, it's gonna be fun.
Absolutely. Yeah. I mean, like it's even women, we're so accustomed to doing that, period. Like cis women, like we take things that are meant for men and we apply it to us. So it's like, it doesn't get, there's no barrier to knowledge. So, but I love that that experience is going to be really special. So tell us how you came to your business.
Oh gosh, what a story. So I would say it starts back in, I won't do this like for 10 years, but essentially, I was working in reality TV down in LA. And during that period of time, I happened to meet a Reiki healer, psychic, and medium. And at that time, I was like super secular, like did not believe in like anything woo, spiritual, anything like that. And cut to like long story short, we ended up having like this really deep connection, and she ended up like initiating me into the whole spiritual world.
Wow.
Yeah, it was really crazy. It was a really weird experience in my life. I remember going home to my now husband, and we're like driving, and I'm like, she told me that like the Virgin Mary just like hangs out around me, and like I remember just feeling like at home, right?
Yes.
And my husband was like, now husband at least, and he was just like, yeah, that makes sense. Which is like, it was such a weird experience. Number one, for it to feel right for me, and for him to just be like, yeah, because he's totally not that
Yeah.
guy either. So long story short, I knew I wanted to help people, and I was really trying to figure out what it was, what it was a fit for me. And eventually, I found coaching. And so I started coaching and I became I was calling myself like a life and career coach, but really I've been a mindset coach from the jump. and women of color, first generation Americans, third culture kids, and immigrants typically just came to me naturally to the point where I just started naturally serving them. And through my own experience, my own decolonization process, I just really realized how important it was for women of color to have spaces where we are not mincing words, where it's just us, and we're able to like really talk about and be held in the things that like someone who isn't melanated as much as we are can't see, and because they don't have that experience. And so that's what really, so my work has always been woman of color forward, but that's what really made me make the switch to woman of color only, which is that I really just wanted to be able to focus on and serve the specific issues that come up for my woman of color clients. And I wanted them to be held in communities where they like felt completely unabashed in bringing it up and talking about it, for one.
Yeah, I mean, like, absolutely, because it's something that's going to affect mindset even more so, which is why, like, I needed to bring you in. When I found you, I was like, oh my God. I was like, this is like an even deeper level of mindset, you know? And it's like the thing with white people too is that, like, we're all racist. Like, it is in there. We have you cannot grow up in a racist culture and not have these things indoctrinated into you. It's the same thing of growing up in a patriarchal culture. Like, whether you are cis, trans, like, whatever, you have internal misogyny. It's just how it is, right? Like, it, and you have that, and you have to work through it. It's part of that mindset work. So I'm so excited that you're going to be in this. So what are some quick tips that somebody watching this can take away where they can like really see how those like societal factors are really playing into their mindset?
That's a really good one. There are a couple of things. The first thing I would always ask, and this is for any, like I'll like bring this out to any identity, but it, or I'll say you can filter this through for any identity, but I'm always going to talk about women and femmes of color first. And so like one thing I would ask a woman or femme of color is like, are you integrating your identity in the way that you do your work, in the way that you talk about your work, in your messaging, in your website? If not, why not? Because it's likely, like, I know for pretty much every woman of color I know, and I'm, you know, even like we'll talk about like cis women or like gender identity, all of those identities, those are some of the most important identities we have. They make up a lot of the way that we interact with the world and the way we show up. So number one, are you talking about your identities? Are they like front and center in your business? And ask yourself, why not? If so, because the story that it's not important, like I think a lot of us have the story that it's not important and, you know, no, like we don't need to talk about it, but really that's actually not true. It's deeply important to who you are as a human being. And we're like all being, like, it's just crazy if we say otherwise. It's deeply important. So that would be my one tip. What else are my other tips? My other tips, okay, are what I would say is, again, looking at the way that you show up inside your business, right? So we talked about externally. Now let's look at inside your business. Inside your business, where are all of the things that you're doing? What are all the things that you're doing right now that you fucking hate?
Right? Yes. Like,
what are all of those things? And then I want you to really look at why. And like, why do you hate those things? What feels wrong to you about them? And what if you, and really what I would want someone to look at is like, what if you just allowed it to be right that you hate this thing? What would you do instead? Instead of trying to, you know, I think so often in the entrepreneurship space, we see coaches trying to have people like contort into doing all these like shitty things that don't feel good for them. And it's like, well, what if we just trusted your actual instinct as a human being and we didn't gaslight that? Oh, and we said, like, why don't we do this in a way that actually feels aligned and actually feels good for you? Because likely what you're going to find is that you're doing things that feel salesy, that feel gross, that don't feel aligned. And you might not have the words for it, but a lot of this, and I know, like, this is stuff that you talk about in your program, Jesse, is that, like, a lot of it is born out of harm. A lot of it's born out of oppressive systems. Like, all of these things that it you know, the looking at like opting people into your email list for after they just signed up for one webinar. It's like, you probably don't like that because it totally removes consent, like stuff like that. So long story short, look at the ways that you're showing up inside your business and where you're doing stuff that you don't like. And if you're doing stuff that you don't like, really give yourself permission to shift it and trust that if you're not jiving something, it's for a good reason. It's not because your mindset's messed up.
I would agree with that. Like, yeah, because your intuition is just as important as anybody else's. So it's like, we can sit here and give you advice on sales or showing up authentically, but if it doesn't feel right to you, you have to find a way to put your spin on things, like just as much as we do. I mean, that's the secret sauce of business. So where can people find you, Giselle?
People can find me. They can find me on the Instagrams. I'm Giselle Allen on Instagram, so super easy to find. You can also find me in my Facebook group. We are called the Woman of Color Entrepreneur Revolution. It's a banging community where we like actually kick it with each other. It's not just me selling at you 24/7 like other communities are. It's really mostly just us hanging out, getting to know each other, buying and selling from each other, and building community. And like, if you are a woman or femme of color, that would be my last tip, is like, find community. We are out here. We feel spread out until you realize that we're all in one place. And so that's what I'm doing, is putting a lot of us in one place.
So I love it. I always good. Like, entrepreneurship does not have to be lonely. And it is until you find your tribe, right? Like, and finding the people there and who are in that space, in that culture, not just of entrepreneurship, but of like your identity as well. Mm-hmm. So thank you so much, Giselle, for taking the time to talk with me today. And I can't wait. I can't wait to see you inside Embodied Abundance. So thank you so much. And we'll talk soon.
Talk to me, my love. Thanks for having me.